Said that poems are the rough notations of the music we are. So I'm not actually a musician, but I do a bit of percussion. But I do work closely with musicians, and I think music and poetry have always been inextricably mixed. And there's certainly music in Yamilka's poetry, and there's also some very hard-hitting confessional thoughts going through. But it's also life-enhancing. I'd hate anyone to think that just by looking at the titles of the poems that, oh, that's very depressing. Read the poems, and I think you'll find that there's this light shining through. And I think that's all poets can do. They can sort of unburden themselves in their poetry, and then leave it up to you, and you will extract different meanings, bound to be. But also you'll get that thread that runs through it that means this is from a poet who has also got a positive outlook on life and has got a love of life and the wonders that life has to offer and the replenishment that life can bring. So I don't want to say anymore. I'm not really sure where I met you, Yamilka. I think it may have been at the Poetry Cafe. It may have been at the Rhythm Factory, which was a sort of poetry music event. But wherever, I was so glad to make her acquaintance and so pleased to be invited here tonight. And I know she's going to read some poems, and I'm going to try and follow that with some English translations. So please give it up again for Yamilka Noa, poet and poet.
Voy a morir en el vacío, en el eco incomprensible de tantas voces perdidas dentro de mis voces. Caigo, caigo, y voy muriendo con cada palabra ambigua. La incertidumbre sabe cómo asesinar.
Echoes. I'm going to die in the emptiness, in the incomprehensible echo of so many lost voices within my voices. I'm falling, falling, and dying with each ambiguous word. Uncertainty knows how to kill.
En busca de la eterna. Este es el último. This is the last one of my poem. Busco con urgencia un beso que me haga eterna, que me calme estos nervios de guitarra que reclaman impaciente psiquiatría. No puedo morir sin ese verso descarado que se paseará con mi nombre por el mundo.
Yeah, I think this is a fitting poem to end on, this selection of the poems from Echoes of Sorrow. Searching for the eternal. I'm urgently searching for a poem that might make me eternal, that might calm these guitar nerves that demand psychiatric impatience. I can't die without this daring verse that will walk with my name around the world.
Yeah.
said it before I read it. Skipping through Mexico City blues, Kerouac praising Charlie Parker, spells it L-E-Y, not L-I-E. Glad I said it before I read it. He even uses the same phrase, lidded eyes. But I said it before I read it. Hear that? Gonna walk with his soul wrapped around my body like a towel. Gonna steam myself in the sauna of his delivery. Gonna guard against cold winds whistling down my spine. Gonna go with his mind on a journey. Accept no lifts from strangers. Anyone asks, I live out over the other side. The other side of that river, that hill, that valley, that long, dirty, dusty road. And anyone else asks, I said it before I read it, I'm true to my word. Ask Kerouac, ask Bird, said it before I read it. Full of my heart, legs dangling over the desolate gorge of my existence. I just want to blow some jazz in a jam on a Sunday afternoon in a windowless room, using the instant karma of Kerouac, flying with the phallic melody of Bird. You get it? Yeah, I said it, baby, I said it. If you didn't listen, oh, there ain't no way you could have heard. Thanks.
Lonely and sad. In Japanese, it's said, 寂しく、そして悲しい。私は想像する。彼女の金は、ホッパーの描く創造物にあるかのように、小さな片隅に人目を引く思想で、強く注意を引きつける孤独な女性。傍ら、瓦屋根、開いてる窓、そして外では満月が、月が、空が、内側ではぼんやりした女性が、それは私、成熟に話しかける。
Green grass and painted toes. Green grass, lush and trim, between my painted toes. Cut grass like an opiate, fills the air with an earthen musty haze. Painted toes, bare smooth hot legs, outstretched, luxuriating. The soft carpet underneath, gently touching and teasing on the back of my knees. Painted nails glistening in the light. Soft thighs rubbing together, Frisian. Sundown pleasure, intoxication born on the scent of the summer. Warm evening air, anticipation, lingering on the tips of my toes and fingers. Daisies blooming around my ankles, pretty chains on pink pert skin that's lightly dampened with a sparkling crystal sheen of perspiration. I know the sweet taste, and yet mingled with a salty tang, a cocktail that rushes my senses, confuses, entwines, arouses, and inspires. A gentle breeze blows, lifting my loose white cotton top from my gently rising breast, and tickles gently, calling for attention amidst the laziness of this feeling. Heat rising. Between my painted toes, I can feel the warm earth. The scent of fresh cut grass floats exotic memories of past encounters. The past gently massaging an almost attainable sense and urgency. I remember delicate moments up high on my inner thigh and around hot lips, tongues flicking, engorged and sweet, my pearls remembered. My pulse flutters now, still gently, still dreamy, still slowly, yet ready, yet holding.
racing with the easy rhythm of the evening, of this evening time. And I look for a long second more down my bike of dawn, and I see lush green grass between painted toes. So closing my eyes, dreams come, touching the edges of this warm sunny place. Well, all I can do is stretch languidly, let this evening have me. A thrill sweeps over, open I give myself up, sigh, smile, and just let go.
You can depend on certainty, count it out and weigh it up again. You can be sure you've reached the end, and still you don't feel deep enough. You're beautiful. Do you know?